Imagine, if you will, our little planet was part of a bigger universe. Actually, forget what I just said. Don't imagine it, take it as fact. Anyway, imagine the premise of what is possible when you mix a game with a classic look like Galaga with a space junkie RTS love child like the Homeworld series. If you were lucky, you might come out with a game like SPAZ. SPAZ being, of course, the name of the game, not that thing that you did when you were 12 and your parents caught you and your girlfriend making out in your room. No. SPAZ stands for Space Pirates and Zombies. If that's not original, I don't know what is. In the game, you play a group of misfit space pirates trying to keep their junk ships together along the way turn into something more. There are 4, and later on 5, major factions. Starting out, it's just the civilians, a militia force called the UTA, and the space pirates, you. The part this game really shines on is its level of customization. Being a spaceship game, 2 things are a given. 1, you have a mothership, and 2, bad people need to be blown the hell up. You can accomplish this through the ships that you build in your hangars. The level of customization on the way you build your ships is absolutely astounding. Each weapon or system has a type of mount associated to it. For example, you can't put a turret where a utility mount like a tractor beam is supposed to go. But, barring that, you can outfit your ships however you like. The amount of ships that you can control is limited only by the quantity and the size of the hangars of your mothership. When you start the game, you can decide how big and therefore how long the game will take you. Smaller galaxies should technically take you a shorter time, but the difficulty level between systems will be much higher than their larger counterparts. The storyline is also voiced entirely by the popular YouTubist Total Biscuit, which is just icing on the cake. The way the factions interact deserves some note. It's not like the Skyrim approach where you do something bad, someone on the other side of the continent knows about it. What you do to a faction in SPAZ in one system has nothing to do with what happens in another. This is because the way the systems are isolated from one another. You can massacre the poor civvies in one sector and be their best buddies in another, which makes for some dark humor by itself. Each system is guarded by the UTA blockade, which you will need to either bribe or destroy to get past to the next system. You can also unlock technologies and research your own tech for ship parts and equipment. Each system has a numerical tech value and type of tech associated with it, being offensive, defensive, or balanced, giving you a rough idea of how tough or hard-hitting your opponents are. Unlocking ships is also interesting, being that you pew-pew them until they explode in a big pile of honky-dory and you gather parts of it to reverse engineer. If you have destroyed and gathered enough hulls to fully reverse engineer it, you can build it. The game involves 3 basic resources that you gather. Res is the stuff that you buy with and build things out of. Data is your basic level up resource that you collect through destroying ships or accomplishing missions. And lastly, goons is sort of a go-between that you can trade for either res or data at most space stations. A good way of collecting these resources is participating in the gladiator-style arena ladder battles at certain space stations for extra cash if you don't want to farm for it yourself. The sound gives you a little atmosphere and the weapons are done well, but I would have liked to get more of the epic space battle feel that I do in other games of the genre. The visuals are nice and crisp, and even the little touches like ramming your hull into the hapless crew of the enemy ship that you just made into scrap metal and seeing them splat is nice. The game's $10 price tag is also a nice bonus. Overall, I feel the game deserves a 9 out of 10 with an area to improve on being the sound aspect of things, and if there is a successor to the game, some multiplayer would be nice. My name is Mr. Thelzar, and this has been my review of Space Pirates and Zombies. Like, comment, subscribe, and thank you for watching.